This episode of the Totally Rad Show is brought to you by Jack Threads. Coming up, when will these guys learn? Badass Liam Neeson hunts them down again in Taken 2.
Today in movies, we are standing here in lovely Century City, California, in front of Fox
Chevy
Studios, to talk about Taken 2.
Retook.
No sub.
This time around, Liam Neeson is taken.
What?
And
the Takener becomes the Taken-E.
As is his wife, and he's got to get untook.
Yep.
She's mistaken.
Really?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow, that's a missed opportunity.
Right.
Yes.
So for the female version.
It's been a while since the first movie. Did you mistaken? Or wait, is it you mistaken?
It is a Luc Besson, Robert Mark Heyman joint. They seem to have these movies down to a science. They seem to be the only people producing, besides Sylvester Stallone now, pure action movies. And to set the scene, a few years ago, Taken came out, and I think surprised a lot of people because it wasn't a high concept movie. It's in fact, quite often used concept about a father trying to get his daughter back. Revenge movie, Death Wish, or
Liam Neeson,
Die Hard.
Out of nowhere, Mr. Action Star.
And I think that's what caught people by surprise was Liam Neeson being the action star and really surprising execution.
Yeah.
So that will be
taken.
Execution of his executions.
Right. Oh.
So this time around, guys, it's a sequel, which says lack of surprise, just inherently.
So interesting you're framing it that way. Go ahead.
Were there any surprises, Alex? Did I surprise you?
Yeah, now I'm surprised.
The old bait and switch. No. Surprises? No, I don't think so.
What did you think?
I mean, you know, obviously, for me, not as good at all as Taken. I think that it was, you know, I'll give them credit that they they had an interesting idea on Taken 2, because at the end of the day, it's sort of like, how do you get away from these, you know, sort of one-off, you know, once-in-a-lifetime crazy moment movies? You know what I mean? And then it's sort of like, taken again. Really, at this point, how would you ever get to, that girl should never travel internationally. You know what I mean? Like, that's how you solve that, you know? So I thought that they had a very clever take on it.
Although, it was, if it's so crazy, you would think it would never happen again.
Right.
If you're the person who lived it.
No, oh, right, yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, you're walking out.
You're going to feel like super safe.
If you've been struck by lightning, you're like,
I can go to the airport. If just because I was at Nakatomi Plaza doesn't mean I can't go to the airport.
Exactly. I can certainly go to New York City.
But I will say that because Taken was such a specific thing that happened,
right,
that they were able to, you know, and my hat's off to them a little bit, though I'm still wearing my hat, that they were able to basically make a plot that was kind of like, I get that would happen after what happened in Taken.
Mm-hmm,
and not like, oh my God, I can't believe it's happened again. You know, it's not like Hangover where it's like, how did it happen again? It's like, yeah, it's a little different.
Yeah.
You know, that said, I think that they, I think that there were a lot, I was surprised that, because I don't remember Taken having as many sort of, I don't know what to call them, but like, you know, just sort of gaffes almost, like lines that were just comically not supposed to be funny, but were very funny, you know what I mean? I feel like with Taken, there weren't any of those, you know what I mean? And here, I feel like there were a lot of, I mean, not nearly as much as here, where some of the stuff was just laugh out loud and not on purpose moments. So I kind of felt like...
I didn't find that to be the case here.
You didn't find the laugh out loud lines?
No, I didn't think they were funny. I thought people were, in our audience, were being snarky because
there
we were
times,
this pretentious
audience. There were times when that was definitely true, when people were laughing at things.
Anytime you hear a laugh,
however,
that's... I can't even do it.
Yeah.
Wait, how do you probably can do it? You know what I mean? The nose laugh? The,
no, I know what you
I
mean.
I can't even do it.
It's called a chortle.
Oh, yeah. It is called like, a chortle. Like, the only reason you're doing that is to tell everyone I'm so above.
Yeah, but here's the thing. Yeah. I think you may have been fooled. Before. I think, no, definitely.
So have you.
But I will say, Jeff, I think you may have been fooled. Because I think those lines came up.
You
started to go, oh, that was.
No, I didn't.
No, I think, and then the chortle happened and you went, oh, it's just chortle people. No, because I was
like
going.
That guy saved you.
No, because I literally was
You were
like,
about to go, and then, oh,
yeah,
it came
were
from
lines
behind.
That guy has a very movie. Particular set of skills.
It is.
In regards to chortling.
So there were lines in this movie that were just like, oh, even. Boy. You know, I mean, the whole, you know, grenade, you know, rope, string, 4.1
miles. I thought that was kind of clever.
Yes, that I think was being saved by the chortle because that was, there was, so there was, so for
Why
me, there
dumb?
Were a
Why
lot of, for me, there was a lot of like, for me, there was a lot of stuff that I was like, wow, this didn't feel as, it just felt like, it felt like they were almost being precious with a movie that had no real reason to be precious about. Do you know what I mean? Like, sure, we get the Liam Neeson character. We enjoyed taking the movie. That does not mean I'm invested at all in any of these characters because it was just a crazy action movie. It's not like, you know what I mean? Like, it's not like it was like Star or E.T.
You're saying it
or
sort
something.
Of suffers from that typical sequel thing where it's like,
we're going to give the audience what they want.
We assume
and
you
we
love
this
that. Family.
Exactly.
When I don't love the family,
exactly.
I loved the.
What happened?
Putting myself in the position yeah. of. A man in this situation yeah. who then, oh, we discover
yeah, exactly.
has a very particular set of skills
exactly.
and is a badass.
So you take, but you take that stuff out of the movie and you still get great action, you still get, you know, I think this is how you should choreograph movie fighting, in my opinion, and for the most part, when I see fighting, I don't buy it. This is the type of fighting, maybe it's just because I enjoy this style of fighting and it feels very visceral and real and you can kind of understand the choreography, but there's a lot of choreography. So it's not just that thing of like, I'm gonna punch you in the face once and then you can follow that choreography because it's really simple. This is very ornate choreography, but it's still very well shot and well put together, in my opinion. So inevitably, I really enjoyed all the action moments, and I think that there was enough there for me to go, this is a pretty good movie. Didn't live up to Taken, but again, I think it does also come down to how surprised I was at Taken. So, you know, I was kind of looking for another version of Taken. And I think for me, there was just some of those, like, people may have found it precious and were sort of doing those things, whereas I didn't find that, so then some of those came off as sort of disingenuous, yeah. But inevitably, a lot of kick action.
Jeff.
Actually, I don't remember a single kick.
You're right, not a lot of kicks, actually.
No, but let's there was some. That. He got kicked in the leg.
Sounds like you, some things were clever.
I thought that,
yeah.
I heard chortles during that particular moment you brought up, and I was thinking to myself, what's with the chortles? because I thought that was in a movie that didn't have
possibly my favorite moment of Total Rad Show. Oh my god, I loved that delivery. I mean,
what's with the chortles?
If anyone's chortling at that, yeah. I'm gonna kick action.
Yeah, baby.
That's a circular callback.
Yeah.
No, but seriously, if in a movie that didn't wasn't overflowing with clever ideas, that I found to be a high point of clever idea. Like, you know, what is so fun about the first Taken is. You have this crazy situation that you are invested in simply because of how possible it seems.
Right.
You know,
yeah.
like girl abducted.
Yeah.
We get that.
Yeah.
And father wanting girl back. We get that. And then all of a sudden, oh, the next level is this guy is the biggest badass, the last person whose daughter you want to take.
Exactly.
And the fun is watching his special skills, his set of skills, in action and seeing, oh, what would the baddest of the badasses do in a situation like that?
Mm-hmm.
Now, as you guys have said numerous times, we don't have that fun surprise, that fun ride. The movie assumes we know all these people and know that he's a badass of badasses. And so it doesn't
so
feel special.
There's sort of a pot boiler situation in the first act where we all know what he's-
We're just waiting.
Which the other movie-
We're just waiting. Okay. We're just waiting for the S to hit the F because we go.
There was a lot of tension in this movie. I don't know. There were a couple scenes where I was just like, I just want to have this over, please.
I feel like this was the perfect example of a film that didn't need a sequel. And yet, anybody that goes into this film thinking, hey, I really liked watching Liam Neeson kick ass, I hope that happens, will get their money's worth.
Yeah, chortled.
You chortled.
You can do it.
You just wait, like trying it over and over, and it just finally worked?
Yeah.
It took that comment.
He was able to make himself burp. Yeah.
I mean, honestly, I don't think this is a bad movie. It's funny, Luc Besson movies all feel the same to me. They really all have a...
His produced movies.
Yes. Yeah. I mean, it doesn't feel like Fifth Element.
Right.
But the movies he's been making in the last 10 years...
Down to a sign. He's like Jerry Bruckheimer was those movies.
It's like his directors are all like cookie cutter guys, and they're all plugging away and making what feels like the same movie. Like, this movie takes place in...
Albania?
Istanbul.
Constantinople.
There was an Albanian in the beginning.
And that is a completely arbitrary decision. It has no relevance on anything other than it gives you kind of a foreign, interesting look.
Yeah, there's cool locations.
It's cool locations, but not taken advantage of in any way, not justified in any way. There's no reason for that.
I don't know if I get that, but I mean, cool locations.
Okay.
That where fights.
But it's just arbitrary cool location. It's not. There's no Istanbul-ness to it. There's no.
I kind of see what you're saying.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, but yeah.
Like, I don't know.
If I could chortle, I'd be chortling.
I'm talking
on both sides of my mouth because this isn't great. It isn't. Doesn't feel special like the first movie did. Yeah. That movie, as you guys have said, you came out of that and you were like, oh yeah,
I'm going to Paris.
This felt like the first Die Hard, or you know, this felt like. Yeah. Something special, a special kind of action movie that I want to watch again and again. And what's missing, I think, not only is the surprise missing, but is any sense of the progress of his journey into getting people back or getting himself broken out being particularly clever or interesting.
He's got a very pure progression in the first movie, very pure story, and this is very... complicated,
right?
And the first movie benefits from like, oh, first you go to that person, and then you go to that person, you get that. So not only was what he's doing to people clever, but also you can kind of follow the path.
And I don't think that upping the stakes in a sequel, I don't think upping the stakes in the sense of bringing in the wife and having more emotional ties for our main character works because. That's already happened. There's no bigger deal than your daughter getting taken, right?
Right.
So I wish they had gone a completely different way and had it be like somebody else gets taken that he's not at all emotionally attached to, and he's sort of reluctant to do it because he doesn't want to kill people, or I don't know.
I think him being taken was a good...
Did it feel like he was taken, though?
Switches halfway through. Then he's not taken. Let me ask you guys something that I wonder if you thought this was interesting or silly, because it could go either way.
Yeah.
This movie, you
can tell based on our chortles.
True. There is, in the action genre, millions of people are killed left and right, all over the place, without any moral ramifications. That's part of a trope of the genre. This movie does attempt, just baked into its sequel premise.
Yeah, which I thought was very interesting.
So that's what I'm asking.
I thought it was interesting or silly that it tries to
comment on the fact that Liam Neeson in the first movie killed
a
bunch of people who had family themselves or whatever.
Yeah, but they were all bad people.
Austin Powers 2 probably did it a little better than Taken 2. But yes, I mean, I think it's sort of half-baked. Like, they don't follow that to any sort of payoff that is worthy of that concept.
Okay.
It's merely just a flimsy premise upon which the revenge storyline is laid.
Yeah.
But I liked it.
Yeah.
I wish they'd gone farther with it.
Yeah, I agree. I mean,
It sounds like you guys recommend it in a way because it's for... It delivers on the promise of its premise,
special, but it's solid.
Not as special as... Yeah. Interesting.
Exactly.
Okay. There you go, guys.
Took it.
Get Taken 2.
All right, everybody, be sure to stick around. We're going to have some lovely outtakes from this week's taping. But first, our sponsors, Jeff.
Dudes.
Oh, boy.
I got something for you. I got something just for the dudes. I'm gonna have to ask all the ladies.
Please leave the
okay,
room.
Both of the ladies that watch the show.
My presentation.
Please step out of the room for 1 minute. I'm just gonna talk to the dudes. Here's the thing. I appreciate Alex interpreting it for the dudes.
For the dudes.
This has been visually enhanced for dudes. All right, dudes. Continue.
No, I'm good. No, I don't
You're
giving
up on the bit.
Well, I don't want people to feel like they're being preached to.
Right. Dudes, you want to look good. It's fall. The fall has fallen. Yep. Autumn is autumn. So you want to get some new, great clothes. You got a whole new chance to wear warmer clothes. You want to look good for the ladies. All those ladies that you just asked to step out of the room, when they step back into the room, you're going to have something in your head. You're going to be like, ladies, I'm going to look fly. The online shopping destination for dudes is going to hook you up. It's called Jackthreads.
Oh.
Perhaps you've heard me mention it once or twice. Everything on this site, this online shopping destination, is up to 80% off. Why?
Why?
Because full price is for suckers and evidently females. Who knew?
What?
But these guys over at Jackthreads will serve up really, really cool brands. They got apparel, accessories, and gadgets. They got brands. There's a whole list of them I could rattle off. Converse, Penguin, Busted Tees, Vans, The Hundreds, John Varvatos, Creative Recreation, New Era, Mosley Tribe, Supra, Nixon, Ben Sherman, just to name a few.
Done.
It's stupid simple, and all the styles are curated. It makes it really, really cool so that the ladies, these guys know what the ladies like.
Bam.
Right? Also, it's back to school time. It's the fall. You're going to want to look good.
Perfect time.
We're going to hook you up. We're going to get you to the front of the line so you don't have to wait. It's a membership-only club. You don't want to know what the ladies know about this, so don't bring them back in the room yet.
Don't tell the 80s. Don't tell the 80s.
Don't tell the 80s. This is a purely new millennium kind of thing.
Yep.
Jackthreads.com/TRS. Go there, do it. Okay, ladies, you can come back in the room now and proceed to enjoy the rest of the show. All right, how much show do they have left to watch? Oh, crap. All right.
Hold on, let me.
Yeah,
there you go.
There
we go. All right.
The whole time
is going to
be
like. I'm way further back. I have a giant head, so if I get space, it's kind of like this way, kind of like evens out. My head's only nominally bigger than everybody else's. Go!
And
Wonder
be,
Twins.
There will be an explosion at it later.
Oh, okay, good.
Yes. I like that.
Yes. Wait, it didn't explode for you guys? All right, you ready?
Yep.
Enjoy that. Here we go. Chipotle. Here we go. Mm-hmm. I have a Netflix recommend.
All right.
When you're in there.
You got it. Sending it your way. Oh.
Sent it too soon. Here we go. Can I have it back? I got it back. Here we go. All right, here we go. You ready?
For one day.
You going there, Mikey?
Come on, let's do this,
okay,
Mike.
Here we go.
Do it.
Well, we don't have anything to read.
Oh, do you want to read it?
I mean, or just mention it to me right before you go.
I'm trying to get the American Horror
in or out.
It's literally right over your shoulder.
That's funny.
That's awesome.
Great.
I mean, I'll say we just want to go.
Yeah, Fox. Let's do it.
Wait, if I look like this, do I look at her?
No, down.
Down.
Should I just poke her eyes out?
Like that.
We'll see you tomorrow.
Mañana.
A callback Thursday. It's Monday. That's why it's callback Thursday. It was for something we're gonna say later.
I wanna be like mañana. It's time for scary stuff.
Hey!
Big, big, big! Shoot, 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 shoot.
Leon!
What? Stick.
But
stick.
Because you wanna watch it.
Shh. Son. Son. Shh. Son.
Son.
Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son. Son